In its statement post to its NEC meeting held on the 2nd till the 4th of July, the ANC says it has noted the final report of the State Capture Commission. The NEC says it also received a presentation by the task team led by Jeff Radebe on action to deal with the recommendations. Now, the party says some findings are unsettling, but has vowed to in fact deal with them in an honest and an open way. Let's look at what then this means with political analyst Moeletsi Mbeki. Mr. Mbeki, thank you so much for your time this afternoon. I mean, when one looks at the State Capture Commission's report, it laid bare some of, you know, what would say the critical workings in government at the height of what many have called state capture. At the same time, you then hear the ANC repeatedly saying that it was finding itself on trial, but this report really is bigger than the ANC and looks really squarely at the workings of government, would you say?
Yeah, well, the commission looks at, is commissioned by the president of the state of South Africa. It's not commissioned by the ANC. So it's very important to understand that it is investigating processes that affect the state of South Africa, not processes that affect any particular political party, whether it be the ANC, the DA, or EFF, or any other political party. So its findings are directed at trying to find, to correct actions that pertain to the management of the state of South Africa, not to political parties.
Now, when we look at the statement that the ANC released yesterday, it says that it, you know, it vows to deal with the findings in an honest and open way to identify some of the shortcomings. And it talks about even, you know, how it's going to be reviewing its deployment policies, among others. Where do they begin to do this in an honest and an open way, as they say?
Well, the ANC can say that it will do... It will respond to the Zondo recommendations, but it is not obliged to do anything about the Zondo recommendations. It is the state president of South Africa who is obliged to do something about the recommendations. So the ANC, well, has its own views, and like any other citizen of South Africa, remember the ANC in South Africa is a private organization. The Zondo Commission is a recommendation to the state of South Africa, not to private organizations.
One would say, though, that the ANC has said that it has found itself on trial. And I remember when you talk about the president, something really sparks, because he said that this deployment policy is aimed at ensuring that the person most fit for purpose, he put it, is appointed, as well as, you know, to address the issues of transformation in various institutions post-apartheid. That raised a lot of questions during, you know, his testimony in the State Capture Commission as to what purpose is this that this individual who's appointed must be fit for?
Well, you see, the ANC leadership does not understand really the relationship between it as a political party and the state of South Africa, which is an institution of the people of South Africa. That's why it's very important to understand that the ANC is a private organization. The state of South Africa is an asset of the people of South Africa. So the ANC has no capacity or no capability of pinpointing who is fit for what purpose. They cannot decide how the people of South Africa should run their state, who is fit for what purpose. Only the Public Service Commission can decide, an independent public commission can decide who should be employed in the state of South Africa, which is a public asset. It's not the ANC's private asset. So the ANC does not understand the difference between itself as a majority party and the state. They think by becoming a majority party in parliament, they become the owners of the state. No, that's not how these things work. The owner of the state are the citizens of South Africa, not the majority party in parliament.
So then I'm listening to what you're saying and how the president should then be responding. We know this report is going to be finding its way to parliament. This is an institution, even during the State Capture Commission, found itself wanting. At some point, its former speaker admitted to, you know, I'm paraphrasing, sleeping on the job and not doing enough to stop state capture. So it seems like parliament is now also going to be under scrutiny, because when you look at their report, they don't come out with a glowing report as well on how now they must, on how they are going to then be responding to some of what the Zondo Commission is recommending.
But no, the Speaker of Parliament is deliberately, in my view, misguiding the population. Parliament was not sleeping on the job. Parliament, which the ANC is the majority in parliament, and it made decisions in connection with state capture, in connection with protection of actions of the then administration, in connection with all the contraventions of the laws that were made during that period. It wasn't sleeping on the job. It was approving of what was being done. So the speaker, of course, is an ANC member and is put there by the ANC and is trying to minimize responsibility on the ANC majority in parliament, to minimize its responsibility for state capture. That's what the speaker is trying to do by diverting attention, saying that the parliamentarians were sleeping. They were not sleeping. They were actually encouraging state capture.
So listening to what you're saying then, do you then have hope that we may see a different parliament emerge here as opposed to a parliament that closes ranks when it comes to majority on some of the implementations, particularly where we need to see some action?
Well, in a way, the country is in a trap, because the main wrongdoer during state capture was the ANC and its officials who are in the executive. Those were the wrongdoers. Now, Parliament is being asked to do something about them. And why should Parliament do anything about them? Because for the majority of Parliament, who are the ANC, they can veto and they vote against whatever action that, for example, Zondo recommends should be taken, or the opposition parties recommend should be taken. The ANC can use this majority to override whatever initiative the opposition and anyone else wants taken against members of the executive.
So then when you look at the statement that came out yesterday, part of the policies that it also talks about that it needs to review is its parliamentary oversight. I'm listening to you. You talk about the vetoing of certain decisions that they may not necessarily be happy with. Then are you saying that you are not confident that it will be able to do an effective review that could see a different parliament when it comes to its own composition? And I'm talking about the ANC's composition here. Exercise its oversight role differently?
I don't see how the ANC is going to work. Well, let me say, it may yet surprise us, and I'm looking forward to being surprised. Up to now, the ANC has, in parliament, the members of ANC in parliament have decided not to make the executive accountable. And that is what has been happening during the past 28 years. The ANC has used this majority in parliament to protect the executive, which is the ANC, from being made accountable to the people of South Africa. I don't expect this is going to change as long as the ANC has the majority in parliament.
Very briefly, we're almost out of time. I'm keen to hear from you on this one. We look at the report, we read various installments of it. It's very clear. It tells us how, corruption may have happened. There's a lot that we now know. But the critical part now is going to be the implementation, action, people behind bars and all of that. How crucial is that going to be to ensure that the work of the commission and the money spent is a justifiable spend for the people of South Africa?
Well, you see, you can have some individuals charged and arrested and even found guilty, but that doesn't change the policies. It doesn't change the policies of the ruling party. So at the end of the day, you can have individuals who the party will sacrifice as the sacrificial lamb. Siyabonga Gama is one of them who they've decided to sacrifice and put up and allow to be tried. But at the end of the day, it doesn't change any of the policies of the government that led to state capture in the first place. And it will not change those.
All right, Mr. Mbeki, thank you so much for your time this afternoon. Appreciate it. That was political analyst Moeletsi Mbeki.